Welcome to Adarsh Vidyalayam Chemistry Online Class. Today we are going to see about matter around us, that is unit number 10. Unit number 10, matter around us. Everything around us is called matter. For example, food we eat, air we breathe, stone, rocks, grain of sand. So, everything is called as a matter. So, these substances, what are these substances? The food we eat, the air we breathe, rock, everything. These substances have two common properties. What are the two common properties? These substances occupy the space. It occupies the space and it has the mass. These are the two common properties. So, from this we will define the matter. So, matter is anything that can occupy the space and it has the mass. That is called as a matter. So, what is the name of matter? Matter is any substance, okay, that occupies the space and it has a mass is called as a matter. So not all the things that we feel is called as a matter. Not all the things is called as a matter. For example, if you take sunlight and the force, sound, energy. So these are the things. They are not having the specific mass and it's not occupy the space. So it is not comes under the category of matter. What are they? Sunlight, force, sound and energy. These are not considered as a matter. Okay? Students, you have already learned the classification of matter based on the physical state in your 8th standard. So, based on the physical state, the matter can be classified into three types. Solid, liquid and gas. So, in 9th standard also, we have another classification of matter. That is based on the chemical composition. The matter can be classified into two types. One is a pure substance. Another one is an impure substance. The matter can be classified into, based on the chemical composition, the matter can be classified into two types. One is a pure substance. Another one is an impure substance. The impure substance otherwise called as an mixture. The impure substance otherwise called as a mixture. Okay. So the pure substance further classified into two types. One is an element, another one is a compound. Pure substance further classified into two types. One is an element, another one is a compound. So now we will see about element. So element. All the persons are like music. Everyone are interested in music. So the music has some fundamental notes. Example, sa, re, ga, ma. So these are the building blocks of music. Similarly, all the substances, every substance on the earth, for example, plants, animals, even our human body, everything contains elements. So these elements are building blocks of the materials. So, elements are the building blocks of the materials or which were substances. Clear? The elements. The scientist Robert Boyle used the name element. Who is the scientist? The scientist name Robert Boyle used the name element. So the element is a very small substance. So it's a very small particle. Element is a very small particle. We cannot be broken further. We cannot be broken further. Elements are made up of. Elements are made up of a similar kind of atoms or one kind of atoms. Elements are made up of a similar kind or a one kind of an atoms. Clear? So elements are the building blocks of all the materials. Elements is made up of similar kind of atom or one kind of atom. Next, we will see about atom and molecule. What is an atom and what is a molecule? Atom, definition of an atom. Atom is the smallest unit of elements. Atom is the smallest unit of element which take part in a chemical reaction. It may or may not exist independently. Okay, so it is the smallest unit of element which take part in a chemical reaction. Come to molecule. Molecule, it is the smallest unit of a pure substance. It is the smallest unit of a pure substance and it may exist independently. It may exist independently and retain physical and chemical properties of that substance is called molecule. Okay, so it retains the physical and chemical properties of that substance, that is called as a molecule. Okay, so in simple way I will say about a molecule. If two or more atoms, if two or more atoms combine together, it form molecule. For example, if we take O2, this is called as an oxygen molecule. Here H2O, this is called as a water molecule. So in an oxygen molecule, how many atoms of oxygen is present? Two atoms of oxygen is present. In water molecule, how many atoms of hydrogen and oxygen is present? Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen is present. So when two or more atoms combine together, then it is called as a molecule. In modern periodic table, 118 elements are present. Students, this is a modern periodic table. This we will learn later. Okay? So, in 118 elements, out of 118 elements, 92 elements are naturally occurring element. Whereas 26 elements artificially created. So, totally 118 elements are present. Come to next classification regarding about an elements. Based on the physical properties of an elements, based on the physical properties of an elements, can be classified into three types. One is metal, another one is metallon, and third one is non-metal. Okay, so based on the physical properties of an elements. So what does mean by physical property? You have already learned in your 8th standard, melting point, boiling point, ductility, shape, color, malleability. So these are all comes in the category of which one? Physical property. Okay. So based on the physical properties of the elements, elements can be classified into three types: metals, metalloid, non-metal. Examples for metals are copper, gold, silver. Metals. What are the properties of metals? Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals can be converted into wire form. Metals can be converted into sheet form, and it have high melting and boiling point. So these are the properties of which one metals. Come to example of non-metals. Examples of non-metals are carbon, oxygen, chlorine. What are the physical properties of non-metal? Non-metal mostly all the gases comes under the category of non-metals. So it have a very low melting and boiling point. Non-metals cannot be converted into wire form and sheet form. It does not conduct the heat and electricity. So these are the properties of which one non-metal. Come to next category, metalloid. So what is a metalloid? Metalloid, the other name of the metalloid is called as a semi-metals. Why it is called as a semi-metal means because the metalloids have the property both the metals and the non-metals. So it is called as a metalloid. Examples for metalloids are boron, silicon and arsenic. Okay. Students, next we will see about compounds. What is mere compounds? When two or more elements combine chemically to form a new substance is called compound. So if I will say the example, we can easily understand. So here NaCl, this is called as a compound. Why it is called as a compound means here two elements are present. Okay, so when one element is in sodium, another is in chlorine. So when these sodium and chlorine combine chemically and it forms a compound NaCl. Okay, so this is the definition for compounds. When two or more elements combine chemically to form a new substance, then it is called such a compound. Students, now we will see the difference between elements and compound. What is mean element and what is mean compound? Difference between element and compound. Element, it is made up of only one kind of atom. Okay. Compound, it is made up of more than one kind of atom. Another difference, element, the smallest particle that retains all its properties is called the atom. Okay, so the smallest particle that retains all its properties is called the atom. Okay, whereas in a compound, the smallest particle that retains all its properties is the molecule. Okay, another difference, element cannot be further broken into smaller substance. Clear? Element cannot be further broken into smaller substance. Whereas in a compound, it can be further broken into a small elements. Elements cannot be further broken into smaller substance. Whereas a compound, it can be further broken into elements. Clear? Example of element is a sodium. Example for compound is a NaCl. So the NaCl is a sodium chloride. Okay. So students, in this session, we have learned what is mean element and what is mean compound. Actually, the matter is classified into two types. One is a pure substance, another one is an impure substance. The impure substance is otherwise called as a mixture. Pure substance further classified into two types. One is an element, another one is a compound. Okay, so that we will see what is mean element and what is mean compound. Thank you.